Good morning, this is Lisa Balsera with USF Health. Thank you for joining us today. This week is Red Ribbon Week, and we're continuing our conversations around substance abuse. This Saturday, October 27th, is DEA Medication Disposal Day, where we can give back those unused and expired medications. Delighted today to be here with Dr. Angela Hill, the Associate Dean of the College of Pharmacy. Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Great. Well, this is a hot topic, medication, give back, take back. Could you explain a little more about that?
Well, it is a topic. For the past 10, 20 years, actually, it's been something that we've raised to the public for concern, primarily based on the fact that there were surveys conducted by the CDC like back in 2010 that actually revealed that there had been enough prescription medications prescribed to provide each adult American a full month supply of medication. And this is obviously very concerning. And then what happens is consumers end up with a lot of leftover stuff, and it ends up in medication cabinets or poured down the sink or flushed down the toilet. And then that creates environmental concerns, also kind of exposures that we don't want. We don't want those kind of medications to get into the wrong people's hands. And so when you look at the need for awareness campaigns and things of that nature. Actually, under President Obama's legislation, there were certain acts and stuff passed to kind of address this, and this kind of mobilized the Drug Enforcement Agency to work with local police agencies, etc., to create awareness campaigns as well as establish these DEA take-back days, primarily focusing on the collection of narcotics and things to try to circumvent the addiction process in that regard.
Excellent, great information. And it's part of the Red Ribbon Week. What is the connection there?
So basically, what we also found in that similar survey is that, interestingly, the abuse of prescription drugs actually exceeds the combined use of cocaine, heroin, and other illicit drugs. And about 6.2 million Americans actually are abusing prescription medications. And so, you know, again, and that was discovered in a survey in 2016. So there's a lot of concern about teenagers, children, even pets having exposure to these kind of medications because of accidental overdoses. Certainly, we want people to benefit from medications, but in a lot of cases, you get a lot of accidental deaths and things that, you know, just naturally occur just because of access. So this is an effort really to hopefully decrease the problem we have with addiction and access to medications that people really shouldn't have access to.
Right, makes sense. So this Saturday is your opportunity to clear out those medicine cabinets, look behind old drawers, and get rid of the expired, unused medications in a safe way. Mm-hmm. So how would I find out where to go to do that?
Well, interestingly, here in Hillsborough County, we have over 30 sites, but if you're not familiar with them, the DEA actually has a website, and consumers can go to DEA Take Back Day, DEA.gov, and actually go to the tab that says collection location site. They just input their zip code, county, etc., and then they can find local sites. We're fortunate, we had a faculty member in the College of Pharmacy that actually established the Musani Health Center as an official DEA collection site, so we'll actually, they'll be able to go there. And then there's predominantly police stations, sheriff departments, fire departments, pharmacies like CVS and Walgreens, and even some of our malls like Wiregrass and Countryside are actually serving as collection sites. And consumers can go to those sites year-round. The DEA Take Back Day actually is focusing on also allowing consumers to bring narcotics and things of that nature. But Hillsborough County has 5 permanent collection sites. And again, with narcotics and things of that nature, we advise consumers to get them to police stations, fire departments, etc.
Okay, so plenty of places
plenty
to go.
Plenty of places,
so,
yes.
And what, lastly, what is the College of Pharmacy and your teams doing to support this effort?
Wow, we have a lot of things going on, one of which is the DEA Take Back Day. So we'll have some of our student organizations actually assisting with the USF Rosani site, and then the other locations around Hillsborough County will have student representation also to assist the police officers with counting and separating and sorting those kinds of the medications that they collect. Then the other thing is our first year students have for the past month actually been raiding medication cabinets of their family and friends as a part of an assignment. They're focusing on collecting non-prescription nutrition, vitamins, and herbal products, and teaching the consumers how to properly dispose of them so they can go in the household trash. And then what we're trying to do is just kind of, you know, support or reinforce the awareness that they shouldn't be flushed, shouldn't be poured, and certainly not just left out for access to other people. And then lastly, our Drugs of Abuse course actually is wearing red ribbons, hashtag RRCOP, in honor of this week. And the Rokai Honor Society is actually selling these ribbons to actually support some of the local efforts towards substance abuse and all. So we have just a few things going on, and more information on our college's website, etc. And then, of course, when we get these opportunities, we're also participating in that.
Excellent. Thank you so much. It's wonderful information.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.